Hi, I'm Jessica Lacey, and I'm a unit coordinator here at Monash University, part of the Department of Paramedicine. Over 20,000 people in Australia suffer from an out-of-hospital cardiac arrest. Bystander CPR as well as pre-hospital CPR can increase that survival rate. Today, we'll show you some of the basics of CPR, as well as some of the skills you may learn when you come here as a student in the Department of Paramedicine. So with every scene, we always start with checking for dangers. Always make sure it's safe to approach for ourselves as well as the bystanders and the patient. Next, we'll check for response. You can apply a painful stimulus to see if the patient is responding. Then you have a quick check of the airway. Make sure there's nothing obstructing it. So to check if someone is breathing, you look, listen, and feel for breathing. What you do is you place your hand on their chest and you feel for rise and fall of their chest while looking at it. You also place your ear to their mouth and feel for any breath on their cheek, as well as listening for any breath. If there is no pulse, CPR begins immediately. Ideally, the patient should be on a flat, hard surface and attempt to expose the chest as much as possible. You should then lock your arms into each other and so your elbows are locked, performing CPR with the bottom part of your hand, trying to achieve a depth of 1/3 of the chest and making sure that you're leaning over the patient and pivoting at the hips so your whole body and your back is straight, therefore your whole body is working into the CPR rather than just your arms. So a heart attack is actually an occlusion within the heart itself, where a cardiac arrest is caused by the cessation of blood flow due to the heart not functioning appropriately. Defibrillation attempts to stop that irregular heart rhythm and begin a normal rhythm. Once the defib has been applied, we continue with compressions. Every situation is different. Normally, the ratio is 30 compressions to 2 breaths. However, if you don't have an appropriate face mask, just perform high quality compressions to make sure you're getting effective compressions done for the patient. Next, we insert an advanced airway. This means we can apply oxygen to the patient while compressions are happening at the same time. The compression to breath ratio would be 15 compressions to 1 breath. However, we don't need to stop compressions as the airway allows us to directly give oxygen into the lungs. Depending on the circumstances, CPR and resuscitation can go for anywhere from 30 to 45 minutes or longer. A career as a paramedic can be very challenging, but also comes with really great rewards. It's amazing when you can actually make a difference on a patient's life and in some circumstances, bring them back to life. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this glimpse into what life would be like as a student with the Department of Paramedicine.